Hi family, it's Christy with Designs for Diva, and in today's video we are going to talk about the four types of manufactured homes. Now we'll go through each type of home, and I have good notes here so I don't forget anything. And then at the end of this video I'm going to show you the process exactly as we went through it, so you can see for yourself exactly which one of the foundations we received for our manufactured home and the process that it took to build that foundation here on the property. So if you're interested in seeing all about manufactured home foundations, make sure you stay tuned and watch till the end of the video. If you're new to the channel, be sure to click the subscribe button and hit the notification bell so you know the next time I upload a video. Old timers, I appreciate you so much. So let's get to the video. So the first one is the crawl space foundation. Crawl spaces are typically used where a traditional site-built foundation is expected. Crawl spaces have many different designs, but only one has worked effectively for manufactured homes. The crawl space foundation is designed for manufactured homes. It's made out of an excavated floor and is typically built using poured concrete footers that go into the soil and anchor the home down. Talk about price range. Now, crawl space foundations typically fall within the mid-range area. What that looks like can be discussed between you and a particular builder, whether it's Clayton Homes or another builder. They can help you to figure out if this is going to be something affordable for you. They can also help you figure out about installation time, which also falls in the mid-range. However, anytime a foundation is being laid for your manufactured home, that will typically be completed by the time your home arrives. So here are four things that you also want to keep in mind. These homes, these crawl space foundations are not something that you want to place in an area where it's prone to hurricanes, tornadoes, etc. However, they will withstand high winds, the higher winds in that area. They are stable. They have seismic resistance. So if you're in an area where there's hurricanes, it can withstand that. But these are not intended for like flood resistant areas. So you want to keep that in mind. Now, when it comes to frost, these foundations can be used in almost any climate and they will withstand seismic resistance. So if you're in an area where there are earthquakes and things of that nature, what you do want to keep in mind, however, is that they will not withstand flood areas. They're not flood resistant and they will not withstand hurricanes. They can withstand the higher winds in areas, but not hurricane and tornado weather. So that's something you want to keep in mind when it comes to crawl space foundations. So the next foundation we're going to talk about is the slab foundation. The slab under a manufactured home acts as a platform for support rather than the floor of the home. The slab typically sits on top of the ground with ground anchors embedded in the concrete. It is insulated around its perimeter, which keeps the ground beneath warmer. Here are some things to keep in mind about slab foundations. The slab foundation is one of the most cost-effective foundations that you can find. There's minimal time needed to install these foundations. They can withstand seismic areas. So if you live in a earthquake prone area, they can be used in high flood areas, but they're not ideal for the sloping land. Like the land that we have was on an incline and had to be leveled off. So they're not ideal if your land is on a slope. They are wind resistant as long as you verify the wind zone requirements for your area. And when it comes to frost, as long as it's an insulated slab, it can be used in areas or lots that hold a lot of frost. So that's the slab foundation. Again, it's cost effective. It's minimal time to put in. It can withhold seismic areas. It can be put in flood resistant areas. So the slab foundation is a foundation that, again, you want to do research on. Even with what's recommended in your area, you always want to do your own research to see if that's something that you can live with. Not only do basements provide a structural support system, but they also add an extra living or storage space to your home. Now, this foundation is not only practical, but it also has a lot of perks. Let's talk about the perks. Cost. Basements rank higher in cost due to their construction time and the materials. They typically have a longer installation time because they take longer to build and install due to their materials as well as their structural design. They can be used in seismic areas or areas that are prone to earthquakes. They cannot be used in flood hazard areas. So you don't want to put your basement in an area that's prone to floods. When your land is inspected, they will determine if this is a flood area or not. So that will help you to determine if having a basement is something that you want in your home. Next one is the Pier and Beam Foundation. And I'm excited to tell you about that one because that's the one that we have. Type of foundation, whether it's pier and beam, concrete, slab, etc., that your manufactured home requires determines the type of anchoring system your home builder will use and install to protect you against the wind. For the common pier and beam foundation, the wind stabilizing system consists of anchors and steel straps and sometimes stabilizer plates. If all three are used together, contractors and engineers call this a tie-down. Engineers will determine your foundation system type by the wind zone, where your home is, the dimensions of your home, the spacing of the beams on the steel frame of your home, the type of soil where your home is placed, and the height from the ground anchor to the steel strap attachment point. So the anchoring system is installed in this way. Anchors are driven into the ground to hold your home down against wind forces. They go into the ground first, and then steel straps are attached. The straps connect the anchors to a main I-beam on your home steel frame.
Whew. I made it through all of that information. So let me just say right now, you guys, that I'm not a professional by any means. I did some research because someone asked some questions. I wanted you guys to know that there were more than one option out there for a foundation for your manufactured home. So I hope you found this information useful. I actually found it on the Clayton website, and I'll put the website right here on the screen so that you can take a look for yourself and review all the information on foundations. Now I want to share with you what our process looked like for our pier and beam foundation. So we've discussed four types of foundations for a manufactured home. Again, you have the concrete slab, you have the basement foundation, you have the crawl space foundation, and then the pier and beam, which is the most common. Beneficial for your home is determined by you and the builder, the land that you've purchased or thinking about purchasing, and what's going to be more cost effective for your budget. So I hope that this information that I've given you has been really helpful. I realize that it was a lot of information at one time. You may have to play back this information, or you can go on Clayton Homes website. I'll put the link right here, and you can see this information for yourself. I can only tell you our experience in purchasing this manufactured home and give you some insights so that it can help you to make a more informed decision for your home. Now let's talk about the foundation that we used here.
First, I want to show you what the land looked like when we purchased it. As you can see, our land sat on a slope. And so we knew that some work would need to go into the home in order to make it stable and safe for our family. So in meeting with the builders and contractors here on the land, my husband and the contractors were able to determine exactly where the home would be placed. Once the home was put in, once they determined that, and we closed the deal on purchasing the land and the home, work began. So, and let me get my notes. So the first step in making sure that the land was prepared for the foundation was to have a machine like this one come out, and this is a small backhoe. I'm going to show you some footage of the day that they came out to level our land. Keep in mind that the contractors had already determined where the house would be, and they put poles down. They also were able to put in a ticket with the city to determine where electrical lines, plumbing lines, gas lines, and everything else was in the ground, so that they knew that they weren't going to dig in areas that would be unsafe for the workers and for our land. Once that ticket was complete and all of the utility services in the area had come out and marked off where lines were, and once we had the electrical lines, because they ran underground where our house would sit, we were ready for action. So here is the day in which the contractors came out with the backhoe, and I'll show you a little bit about the process of them leveling off the land. So once that was complete, then it was time to pour the concrete. As you can see from this video, they're digging the trenches in which the concrete would be poured. Once the trenches were dug, the concrete truck came out and poured the concrete in all the sited areas, poured the concrete in all the sited areas. Now, it took some time for that to harden, and we also had weather issues. I believe the day after the concrete people came, or maybe 2 days after, it rained for like a week, and then we had to wait on the land to dry. The concrete was already dry, but we had to wait on the land to dry before they could then bring the home. And so keep that in mind also. Sometimes weather conditions will delay the process. I know I've had several people to comment that their home they're waiting on their home to be brought out, or their home has been brought out, but nothing has happened. So a lot of things go into determining when there's the right time for all of these things to take place. The contractors will need to organize everything. Weather is an issue. So there are a lot of reasons why it may take a little time, or it feels like it's taking a lot of time. But really at the end, you'll say, man, that happened really fast. And you'll be so excited to be in your new home. Once the concrete was poured out, then it was time to bring out the home. And I'll show you a little snippet of them putting the home up.
You don't need one!
well, there you have it. So once again, there are four types of foundations: pier and beam foundation, slab foundation, basement foundation, and crawl space. Your builder to determine which one is going to be best for you and your home. And before you get to that point, make sure to do your research to see which one you're interested in for your home. Thank you so much for watching. I hope I answered all your questions. If I haven't, please put them down in the description box. Have a great night.